Wow! Today Snehalata is very much excited. Do you know why, children? As because all the children of the primary section are going to Bhopal along with their teachers. Do you know the number, total number of children they are going to Bhopal? Yes, it is given in the table. Look at the table carefully. For class 1, the total number of children are going. Tell me, what is the total number? It's 33. From class 2, 32 children are going. From class 3, 42 children are going. From class 4, 50 children are going. From class 5, 53 children are going. Are you very much excited, isn't it? Because you also want to go to somewhere as for excursion. So what is the total number of children over here? Yes, it's 210. Now Snehalata is very much excited. She was speaking, "We are 210 students. Each big bus will carry 50 of us. So how many buses we require?" Chintu is in a problem. He is speaking, "Oh, I think we require 4 buses. Do you know, children, why? Because 50 into 4, it will give 200. And extra 10 of us, they will adjust in their different shifts. As Chintu is telling over here, that we are extra 10, adjust or share the seats with each other. So I think the 4 buses will be enough for these 210 students. So both of them are very much excited. But at last, small mini buses have come. Each mini bus carries 35 students. So how many buses have come? Now let's calculate. For one bus, 35 children can go. For two buses, how many? Yes, it is 70 children. So 70 children can go in two buses. For three buses, it is 105 children can go in three buses. For the four buses, 145 children can go. For the five buses, 180 children can go. And at last, for the six buses, all 210 children can go. So there is nobody to share their seats with anybody else. So they are very much happy. Though the small minibuses have come, but still all the children can accommodate in these six buses. So there are six minibuses have come to carry 210 children. Wow! All the children run and join their buses and start their trip to Bhopal by 9 o'clock only. See, so many children with Snehalata, Chintu, so many children. All the six buses are waiting for them outside. All of them are running and running towards their buses. Oh, so much excited they are. Taking their all luggages, taking their tiffins, water bottles and all that. Most of them have taken small cameras also to take the snacks over there. So they are so much excited. They're running towards the buses. Oh, I think you are also you are too excited to see them going to a Bhopal trip. All the buses are waiting for them. As they will get up, the bus will start. On the way, they pass over the bridge. See the bridge, it is there over Narmada River, which is 756.82 meter long. See the bridge over there, the buses, all the buses are going over this bridge. Why? they have to cross the river Narmada. Now can you guess the length of this Narmada river? If the bridge is 756.82 meter long, what would be the expected length of this Narmada river? Might be shorter than this? Must be shorter than this, because bridge length is always greater than the length of the Narmada river. Now after crossing the bridge over Narmada river, all the six buses have to refill the petrol because they are in the verge. So they reach to a petrol pump to refill the buses. Obviously they came to petrol pump as you see in the picture. Can you guess how much amount of petrol they have to take in the six buses? Yes children, it is 100 litre. And if 1 litre costs rupees 35, what is the cost of 100 litres of petrol? Just tell me, too fast. Yes children, it is rupees 3500. So this 3500 rupees, it is shown in the petrol pump over here. So Chintu is speaking here, already it has taken 100 litres, so much of a big tummy it has. Nehalata, she is telling, she is counting the number, she is counting the amount they have to pay for it. We have to pay rupees 3500 for the diesel. They are taking the diesel in the petrol pump. Now can you tell children, which are the transports take diesel and which are the transports take the petrol? Have a difference, make a report in your copy and show me afterwards. So if 100 litres equal to rupees 3500, what is the cost of 1 litre? It is rupees 35. Now at last they reach Bhimbhetka at 11 o'clock. Children are really excited to see the cave paintings in Bhopal. It is the Bhimbhetka where you will find out the different cave paintings of different animals like deer, the ox, the buffaloes. Wow! Chintu was so much excited. He was speaking, even 10,000 years ago, people made such lovely paintings, that too on rocks. It is really marvelous and splendid to look at the cave paintings. It's a hard work, but the people of last 10,000 years ago, they were much more competent to make this rock painting. It is quite difficult now for the people to make the rock painting, isn't it? So Snehalata immediately she started calculating. 100 years means 1 century. So how many centuries make 10,000 years? Now children, can you calculate? If 100 years make 1 century, what is? How many centuries are there for 10,000 years? In 10,000, how many zeros are here? In 10,000, there are 4 zeros. If 2 zeros you cut, then how much remaining? 100. Why 2 zeros cut? Because 100 years means 1 century. So 100 centuries means 10,000 years. Now they have a lunch time. All the children, they are really very much hungry now. They want to take the lunch time after this long journey. They want to have some food inside their stomach. So now there are certain tips. Each child has to be given 1 orange, 1 banana and 5 biscuits. But all the children take oranges and biscuits and 38 children do not take the bananas. Now children, just have a mental exercises. How many oranges, biscuits and bananas are distributed? Now see, just mentally you do it. There are 200 children. So each child got oranges and biscuits. Then 200 oranges, 210 oranges plus 210 biscuits are distributed because there are 210 children. If there are 210 children and if each one is given one orange and one banana, obviously 210 oranges plus 210 biscuits are distributed. No, you are wrong over here. 210 into 5. Isn't it? Because 5 biscuits are here. So 5 into 210. So now do this, calculate and then find out how many bananas, 38 banana or whatever you have got over there, you just do a minus it, because out of 210 children, 38 children didn't take the bananas. So how many children have taken the bananas? So 210 minus 38 equal to 172 children have taken the bananas. So how many biscuits? 210 into 5. Do it orally and tell me the answer. So that much of biscuits have been distributed over these children. Now children, have a puzzle time. I gave 4 toffees each to 4 of my friends and 3 toffees are left with me. How many toffees did I have? I gave 4 toffees each to 4 of my friends. Each to 4 of my friends. And 3 toffees are left with me. Now how many toffees did I have? So how many toffees, first you have to calculate how many toffees I have given to my friends. There are 4 friends and 4 toffees. So 4 into 4, it is 16 toffees I have already distributed to my friends. And still after that, 3 toffees are remaining with me. So how many toffees I had? I had 16 plus 3 equal to 19 toffees with me. So this thing you can do orally and ask your friends to calculate and give the numbers. Have a game. Have asked this question. Have a collection of these questions and ask your friends. Second question I am asking here. What numbers can you make using 3, 5 and 7? You can make 3, 5, 7 and 5, 3, 7. And what others? What are the different numbers you can make over here? A number becomes double if it is increased by 8. What is the number? Think of a number which becomes double if it is increased by 8. So what is the number? Calculate it. Think of a number which can be divided by 2, 3, 5 and comes between 25 and 50. Wow, how many of you had a boat ride? So many boats you are finding over here. Different colors of boats, different sizes of boat, and different, they have the different names of boats. Now here you will see different kinds of boats, different types of boats. One is canoe boat. I think all of you are seeing this picture. Next one is house boat. Another one is sloop. This is called sloop of a rowing boat. These are all different kinds of rowing boats. Another is outboard. Another is yacht. So many different kinds of boats you can use. Some of the boats are also the fishing boats. They are only used for this purpose, only to catch the fish by the fishermen. Now see, there is a table given here. The children, they are very much excited to have the boat ride, but there is a charge. They have to pay money for this. So there are different kinds of boats and each has a different ticket price and also different trip time. The name of the boat is Double Decker. Its ticket price is 30 rupees and the trip time 45 minutes. So each individual, they have to give 30 rupees for 45 minutes trip. Next one is paddle boat. It is taking 15 rupees each for 30 minutes trip time. Motor boat. It is taking 25 rupees ticket price for 20 minutes trip. And another one is boat with the oars, which is taking 15 rupees for each for 45 minutes trip time. Now one exercise I have given to you. One group of children went for the double decker trip. They paid rupees 450 in total. How many children went for the double decker trip? Total they have paid 450 rupees. So one child will go, if one child will go, he has to pay 30 rupees. For two children it is 60, for three children it is 90, for four children 120, for five children 150, for six children 180. So accordingly you go on and find out how many children will go, have to go for rupees 450. It's a work for you, it's a homework. Find out. After that, they enjoyed the